Hi everyone, and welcome to the .NET MAUI checkbox tutorial. The checkbox can function either individually or as part of a group. You can use it in filters to select multiple options. When used individually, it is typically employed for binary yes or no choices. In this video, I will demonstrate how to add Syncfusion's .NET MAUI checkbox control to a .NET MAUI project. I will show you how to customize the appearance of the checkbox text. I will also show you the different states of the checkbox and how to customize them based on their state. Before you begin, make sure you have installed the latest version of Visual Studio 2022 with the required .NET MAUI workload. You should also have one of the .NET SDKs installed on your machine. After installing the necessary tools, launch Visual Studio 2022 and click Create a New Project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, select the .NET MAUI application. Then, give the project name and location. Next, create a project with the .NET 7.0 framework. Now, the default application is ready to use. Before I move forward, let me set up the application's environment. Here, I select the Android emulator from this list to see the output in the Pixel 5 emulator. After selecting the emulator, I'll run the application to show you the default output. The application compiles the default code, so wait for a few seconds. Now, the application's homepage is displayed. Next, let me show you how to incorporate the checkbox control into this application. For that, I need to install the Syncfusion MAUI button's NuGet package. So, I first open the NuGet package manager and switch to the Browse tab. I search for the Syncfusion MAUI buttons package and select it to install in my project. Once the package is installed, I need to register the handler for the Syncfusion core to map the cross-platform control API to the native view API. So, I open the MAUI program CS file and add the Syncfusion MAUI core hosting namespace. Then, register the Syncfusion core handler by adding the configure Syncfusion core method. It is necessary to register a trial license key to use the Syncfusion MAUI controls. So, I open the app XAML CS file and add the register license method with the trial license key. To find out where to generate it, refer to the link provided in the instructions in the description below. Next, navigate to the main page XAML to initialize the control. Remove the default code from the content page section and import the Syncfusion MAUI buttons namespace. Initialize the checkbox control. Set the text to show password, width request, and horizontal options. Enclose this checkbox within a stack layout and set the vertical options to center. Look here, the checkbox is displayed on the emulator, and you can check and uncheck the checkbox. To programmatically check a checkbox, set the isChecked property to true, as its default value is false. See, the checkbox is enabled during initial loading. Next, I will show you how to create a group of checkboxes that can be used in multiple scenarios. I'll replace the existing checkbox with a label element. Set the stack layout vertical options to start, and then add the required properties to achieve a customized appearance for the label. I'll set the text to pizza toppings and customize the label by configuring its background, font size, font family, font attributes, height request, and horizontal and vertical text alignment properties. Then, add four checkboxes below the label for pepperoni, beef, onions, and mushrooms, each with corresponding text. Looking here, four checkboxes are displayed, allowing you to select one or more. Now, let me show how to customize the appearance of the checkbox text. To demonstrate this, I use the style. It can also be set in the control. First, open the Content Page Resources tag. Inside this tag, open the Resource Dictionary tag. Then, define the style property and set its target type to checkbox. Next, use the setter instance to set the text color to blue, the font size to 16, the font family to Arial, and the font attributes to bold. Looking here, the text is in bold, and the text color and size are also customized. Next, I will show you the different states of a checkbox, including checked, unchecked, and intermediate. The checked state occurs when the item is selected, while the unchecked state occurs when the item is deselect. The intermediate state occurs when a group of subchoices contains checked and unchecked items. To demonstrate this, add a new checkbox. Set its name and text to select all. Then, wire the state changed event to a new event handler method, and adjust the left margin of all checkboxes to distinguish the subgroup checkbox. Now, wire the state changed event to the new event handler method for the other checkboxes. Let's navigate to the main page CS and locate the event handler method for the select all checkbox. Here, write the logic to synchronize the isChecked value from select all to the other checkboxes. First, check if the value of isChecked from the event argument is not null. If it is, set the isChecked property of the remaining checkboxes to isChecked from the event argument. In the event handler method for the other checkboxes, check whether all the checkboxes are checked. If they are, set the select all checkbox isChecked property to true. Similarly, if all checkboxes are unchecked, set the select all checkbox isChecked property to false. In any other case, set the select all checkboxes isChecked property to null. See, when you select the select all checkbox, all the other checkboxes are checked. Conversely, when you deselect it, all the other checkboxes are unchecked. If one or more checkboxes are unchecked, you will observe that the select all checkbox enters an intermediate state. Finally, I will show you how to customize the checkbox color for different states. To achieve this, in the style, set the check color property to an appropriate value using the setter instance. Similarly, specify a color for the unchecked color property. For the intermediate state, create an instance for triggers. Within this, add a trigger and set the target type to checkbox, property to isChecked, and value to null. Add a setter instance inside the trigger, setting the property to checked color and the value to purple. Now, you will observe the checkbox colors are changed based on their state. In this video, I have demonstrated how to create a .NET MAUI application and incorporate a Syncfusion checkbox control. I showed you how to customize the appearance of the checkbox text and programmatically select checkboxes. I also showed you how to add a group of checkboxes and the different states. To learn more about checkbox features, you can check the documentation link provided in the description below. I have also included a link in the description to check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire .NET MAUI control suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.